And many Republicans slammed the decision to block the pipeline, including presidential candidate Newt Gingrich.
KOCO's morning anchor Anita Blanton spoke to Gingrich today, and in Commitment 2012, he shares his plan to save the Keystone Pipeline.
There's currently a bill in the works to try to circumvent what the president is doing and fast track the pipeline. You've said that there's a hypothetical theory you have. Would you talk a little bit more about that?
Well, look, I would support a bill, but they'd have to override his veto, which I don't think they can do in the Senate. So what I've said is that on the very first day I'm president, on January 20th, I will sign a executive order authorizing the pipeline to be built as of that day. And I've urged the Canadians to be patient. Give us a few months. Let us beat Obama. Do not cut a deal with the Chinese to build a pipeline due west across the Rockies. It's much more expensive. We want that pipeline to come through the United States. We want it to bring us Canadian oil, which helps our energy security.
Anita Blanton reporting there. There is a recent poll that shows Gingrich has the lead here in Oklahoma. But overall, Rick Santorum is surging. There is a national poll that shows Santorum has a 2-point lead over Mitt Romney. In another poll, he skyrocketed 14 points in less than a week. All the momentum for Santorum has Romney spending big money on ads to defend himself.